coffee. Hey, we're back with Arcanums. Arcanors. As you may recall, last time around on the old Dernhelm, we fixed their garbage. It's still a garbage place because the wrongful ruler is on that, and yeah. As you'll find, we did not make that better at all. We, in fact, made it pretty much the same. Yeah. And I know, some people have pointed out, your followers are doing all the damage, and then you don't make all the bang boom, and not everything's great, and that's true. Unfortunately, the way damage is done is if you are a gunslinger or a melee fighter at this point in the game, you're going to be way powerful. I mean, way powerful. Oh, yeah. So, that's just one of the things that you're going to have to acknowledge. Alright, we're going to go there, and we're going to go there. And, we're going to have to actually get up to the Black Mountain Mines here shortly, but I need to try to settle a thing or two in Tarant if I can. I'm going to do my best to settle a thing or two in Tarant, okay? Also, I'm going to turn up my audio gain just a little bit so you can better hear my voice. Some people have complained about my audio. These people are new to my channel. The people who've been around a while kind of go, yeah, Texas audio is going to be fucked up. It generally is for one reason or another. Because I don't separate these tracks as audio and blah, I just record it live, so unscripted and bad for it, obviously. Man. You ever have a companion that was so mighty that they managed to, like, cut a bear in half? Like, crack open a bear with the boys! Oh, boy. So, yeah, my style is kind of, not a style. I tend to just, shoot shit live and, you know, sort it out. That's kind of what I do. I'm not really a, professional at all. Some of you already know this, but I'm just letting you know, this is the way it goes. And the game keeps trying to kill me, by the way. Its Rain Jesus module is like, more wolves, less wolves, more bears, less bears, more bears and wolves. Wow, really, bears and wolves? No, my wolf, but still. We are murdering the shit out of nature. There'd just be a stack of carcasses between here and Tarant. Oh man, I love it. So, what do I want to do in this city? Well, one, I want to, I mean, I'm a pretty magical motherfucker at this point. I mean, look at that. Look at all that shit. If you saw someone wearing all that coming up to you and they're like, what ho, good citizen? You'd be like, wow, that guy's pretty weird. And the other thing is, I wanna load up on some basic magical potions and shit. I really need some basic magical potions. By the way, this guy here is loaded. If ever you want to rob places, I'm not saying you should commit crimes, but if you were to commit a crime and he was the one you chose, I would say you chose well. Alright, so we're going to go into the Black Mountain Mines, and the Black Mountain Mines are horrific. They are fucking horrific. They are fucking horrific. Alright, let's try read. Let's see. What older newspapers do you have? Zephyr Missing, Don Throg at Large, Train Wreck at Vermilion Station. I changed my mind. You can read the old papers as time goes on. They'll have a few old editions, and there are crimes and things you can solve in them. So, just fun fact. And yes, there's 1,000 threads back in that town. 1,000 little threads you can pull on for story. Little story hooks are everywhere. They peppered it throughout this town. They wanted you to spend a lot of time here. Alright. We're gonna try to fight these guys, despite my best, despite my best wisdom here, I'm gonna try to wade in there and sort out these neighborhood toughs with a bit of pizzazz and what have you. So I'm gonna open the gate to hell. There we go. And then I'm going to have some drank. Alright, and then I'm going to tell my demons to attack that gentleman. Alright, there we go. And I'm gonna tell that demon to attack that gentleman. And then I'm going to cast Harm Some. However, this, you have to understand, this place is so fucking tough. This part of town is so fucking tough that they can actually fight and kill demons. Like, these are really tough bad guys. These are not just like normal neighborhood toughs. Like, they're like, ah, demons on a territory. We ought to fuck him up, you know? I mean, they're really tough dudes. Yep. One demon's almost dead. Oh, man. Alright, I can send these guys back and join the fray myself. Oh, I missed. He missed, thank God. Yeah, I would not enter the boil, sir. Thank you for the warning. No, I handled it. You're welcome. And here we go. This guy's like a shit little tradesman, but if you're stuck down here and can't run fast, he'll buy it off you. And he'll fix your shit for you. Most people forget this little fucker exists. They're like, ugh, a halfling. I won't do truck with a halfling. And you shouldn't, because they're like little fucking bastards. I mean, if there was a periodic table of assholes, halfling would be down there near Hafnium. Mainly because they're similar. Similar properties. Also, coca leaves grows naturally here, that close to a big city. Ugh. Let's get into the Forbidden Pit and kill some things for some XPs. I need some XPs. Oh, yeah. That stupid castle. I'd prefer to watch you die, because I'll use magic on your face. Ow. Exactly. Now give me your fucking lunch money. I want your lunch money. That's it. We're gonna go to the Forbidden Pit. We're gonna go explore a castle. We're gonna do some bullshit. Look at this pit. Look how forbidden it is. It's got some spiders down in it, and it's got a ladder. There. Handled. It really seems like some sort of tourist trap. Come to the Forbidden Pit on the plains. You mean that hole you dug? The Forbidden Pit? It contains spiders. You put the spider. Oh my god. Okay, we have a problem. These are greater spiders. It means they're pretty great. They're like the Freddie Mercury of spiders. Oh my god, my poison level 17. This could be bad. Yeah, look at my poison level. Look at that. Alright, I may be in peril here. Because I have... I'm just going to have to keep boosting my hit points here. While the poison slowly works out of my system. Is the issue with Arcanum is sometimes you'll sit there and think you want to fight and get poisoned and realize that, no, you didn't. You'll kill the bad guys, but whatever comes along and poisons you finishes you off, and it's fucking horrible. Arcanum is a game that just doesn't give a fuck. I should have used some of these other spells, but fuck. I could have used the I push you away spell, also known as the no thanks spell. So, look, I wait for 1 hour? Okay. Sit there and resist it barely. God, poison. Poison in Arcanum is no fucking joke. Oh, that ended well. I love the soundtrack to Arcanum. Just strings. Couple of guys with some string instruments. I need music for meandering around civilization. Ah, yes, very well. And what key? Ah, yes, a town of general sundries and what have you. Yes. Let us barter, my good woman, and I will overlook the fact you had a halfling or a gnome in your quarters last night. Most indecent, that. Most indelicate. If the town were to find out, by Jove. By thunder, the things they would say. I will be gone. That one, he is most small. Your taste in men is terrible, madam. Should the papers get a grip of it, you shall find yourself outcast from society and imperiled by how alone you are. God, Victorian era would have sucked for a lot of reasons. Would have been fascinating for a lot of reasons, too. But mainly sad. So, here's what we're gonna do. Is we're gonna... we're gonna go play with that castle. I like me a haunted castle. I like me an old spooky castle. Because that's where treasure might be. And the treasure this time is not friendship. The treasure is XP. Sweet, sweet XP. I need it. Here we go. Yeah. Oh man, look at all them zombies. Look at them. Just chock full of zombies. Chock full of zombies. Alright, well, here we go. I spell cast fast. I'm just gonna clean them out. I'm gonna be the magical equivalent of a Tommy gun. Just going room to room. Oh man, look at that. I'm blowing shit up. And there's one. You're welcome. Another level for me. You know what? I like fire. Let's just go ahead and get closer to the game equivalent of fireball. Because we're gonna need it. We're gonna need the shit out of it. This game is gonna need so many fireballs. There we go. Suck back another potion. Hopefully this isn't laudanum. What a nice chair. No, it's shitty. It's got those rivets on it. That would just be terrible. Alright, he's done. Alright, we're gonna open this chest. It's unlocked. Surely it's not trapped. It's not trapped, holy god. And it has a key. And now we're going to begin exploring. But first we gotta clean out the rest of these zombies. Also, if I clean out these zombies, is that a civic service? Am I like the equivalent of the rat catcher, or the dog catcher, or the bum catcher, or whatever you have? Wherever you live. Bum wrangler, you know, the elf stamper, whatever your thing is, whatever your doodad is, I don't know. I mean, each municipality I know has its own rules on the unwanted population that lives there. So, I think that largely this would be a municipal job. Like, hey, we got some animate undead, and they're by the candy store, and this guy is really having a hard time making hard candy because of the undead that are there, that are just milling around. They're not biting anyone, they're just milling around. They are undead. The guy's trying to have some fun in the sun. He's got an ice cream social. He's making some whorehound candy, and these things are just walking around biting stuff. I mean, they're just gnawing. They're just ow, 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 ow. And, you know, he's really having a hard time. So you're going to have to go over there and take care of that and return them to their graves or whatever. Honestly, I think the city would license necromancy, and then you'd have, like, necromantic lawn services. Oh, that looks nice. Heavy rags. Master lets me wear the heavy rags. Ugh. Alright, let's take our drugs. Yeah, boys and girls. Drugs. And what's fun is if you make a party of people who use guns, which will be my next Let's Play, will be a party of people who uses a lot of firearms and explosives and technology. Yeah, I might make a gnome so I can just be like, oh, you got gnomed! Go away. Yeah, that's how you handle that. We're just gonna grind this place for some XPs. 1,001 spoops! Oh man, look at all these guys. So many zombies. But we're appropriate level to where they're not really a threat to us. So I can just run around and just beat the shit out of these guys. If you show up here at the right levels of success, oh boy. When you are the right XPs, this is easy peasy. The most unsettling library. Yeah, I'm gonna need some heavier level spells. I can't insta-nuke level 6 people anymore. That's when you realize it's time. Excellent, another level for me. I will become magical asshole. Oh wow. He smacked me and it hurt even my feelies. Do you think they do this just to get adventurers to come to their town? Like, hey, go raise some zombies in that castle and just sprinkle like 10, 15 gold in each room. And yeah. And then when the adventurers fucking get smoked, someone goes in there, dispels all the zombies, and gets the shit back. Am I horrible in thinking that's a business? Listen to that. Yeah, no. Me yourself. Oh my god. The bows he possesses and the accuracy. Oh my god, look at that. Thank god I got my party of winners here. My company of heroes. Oh yeah, here we go. Well, he knows how to increase his accuracy, that's for sure. I fall down because lack of the fatigues. Alright, let me just tear my people loose in here. Turn it back to fast and go. Listen to that. Holy god. Sog Mead Mug. Wow. He got shot with like 8,000 arrows. So let's heal him. Holy Jesus. You gotta be careful with them bows. The real weapons of mass destruction in this setting is bowmen. Holy fuck, man. Listen to that. My god, they killed the dog. Oh my god. Oh my god, they're killing the whole party. Oh no. No! Oh, how horrible. Thank god I saved in the castle. Oh my god. That is insane. Yeah, the Never underestimate your enemies in Arcanum, which is a mistake I make often. Just letting you know that they resprited a bunch of stuff because I think they ran out of art essence. And when that happened, they kind of... You get stuff that looks kind of similar, but it's not. It's really not. When that happens, you're gonna run into Skellington McShoot Hands, and oh my god, could you imagine that? Like, you're in your dungeon or whatever, and you hear like a really fast clinking sound of like bone on bone, and you're like, what is that? And they're like, oh, that is nothing. It's just the fast skeletons. You're like, the fast skeletons? What does that mean? And you look up, and like that arm is moving like a fucking sewing machine. You're like, oh dear. Oh dear, dear, dear. I mean, he's attacking like 100 times a turn, and you're like, oh my god, why have I done this? I'm just gonna sit in the back and cast harm a lot. Oh man. Go me. Alright, we gotta clean up this floor again, but now that I know what I'm doing, kind of, I'll do it a little faster. And I'll save a little more, because some of you know better than that. It's locked. But I have the key, my friend. Oh wait, yeah, maybe I just gotta go around. Beware the Skellingtons. 10,000 spoops a night. They're very spoopy, you know. No, don't fight me. I'm looting. I don't think zombies or skeletons would be all that scary. I mean, they're not that strong. I mean, okay, animated. I'm sure they could be made pretty beefy, but... Oh god, why am I doing this? I can unlock anything with this thing called fucking magic. Oh wait, no, wrong one. Yeah. Yeah, see, oh, still locked. Oh, really? Okay. Alright. More than one way to unlock a door, sir. Exactly. Oh my god. Oh my god, they killed the ogre. Jesus. Sock Mead Mug just got wrecked. No worries, I have a scroll for that. I do. I can't just fix the whole party. I kind of miss Virgil.
Sir, help me! I'm being attacked! Sir!
Do, Virgil. Alright, where's my, Scroll of Resurrect. There we go. Coffee brought to you by Nun Brand. That's right. Okay, where's Sog? Yep, there he is. Okay, I cannot see his body, which makes this a little dangerous, but hey. And he's back. How can I help you? No, it's alright. Everything's fine, Sog. You just had a nap. Those scrolls are worth every penny. Oh, Lord of the Damned. Is that like Lord of the Dance? And they've written all sorts of nasty words on the walls and shit. Locked. It's dumb. Still locked. You know what? Fuck you, magic chest. I'm gonna go back upstairs. I think this is obviously the last part where you're supposed to get a key for it elsewhere, and I just kind of brute forced it, but fuck you. You don't tell me where I can go in games. You just reinforce those choices with violence, like everything else. I love that. That's the sound they make. Watch fucking Pablo when he edits this. He just puts, or he gets like Kobold or somebody to remix into a song. Skeleton Noises, the musical. And here we go. A castle of 1001 spoops. Alright, ooh. Because, yeah, if I remember correctly, there's the upper floor that's full of machine gun bowmen, and that's not the worst of it. It gets shiftier after that. Like, it gets way shiftier after that. If I remember correctly. But look, I got Fireball, man. And once you got Fireball, as we all know, most of your spellcasting decisions are simplified. It's how much violence do you want to use, and the answer is usually yes. Kill him, I'm busy. You can make a lot of very easy low-level gains in this game. And I do mean a lot. Yeah, I have another Scroll of Resurrect. And I have a Scroll of Exiting, which is fucking cool. It just takes you to the outside of the dungeon, wherever you're at. I think in the game, standard-wise, the first one you find is in the Black Mountain Clans, which, if you don't know how to detect traps, you're gonna need a Scroll of Trap Detect or some very strong feat. You'll find out why. Because that'll probably be next episode. Maybe. Maybe will be next episode. Because I'm doing some meandering around, because part of me goes, I kind of remember this place. The other part of me goes, no, you don't. You should go do that and die. Because people will laugh. And I, you know, there is some of that. Sog, can you please quit dying? It is so expensive. It is so perilously expensive, sir. Please quit perishing. I cease it at once. Ugh. Trying to give everyone their magical potions and what have you. Alright. Yeah. What a rough time. Here we go, boys. Into the breach, dear Nins. Oh, no. Oh, God. Oh, my God. Look at that guy. Look at him. Stop him. Stop him! He shoots like a sewing machine. Oh my God, he killed everyone. Oh God. Alright. This is where you're gonna really appreciate turn-based. Certain parts of this game are better turn-based. Because he attacks a billion times around, and, alright, I'm gonna need some magical help. Where's my potion of crack? First of all, this one. I need me some good old, 24-hour energy. Not 5-hour energy, 24-hour energy, which can only be made on Space Station 13. And then, now that I've got that, not the intellect boost, the big smart boost, big brains boost, did I grab a crack potion? Yes, I did. This is the potion of meth. Alright, so, now that I've got that. Skellingtons. Yeah! Now I'm just gonna run up there and start wrecking shit. Alright, so, next thing, I gotta heal him. I know I'm just slinging potions, mainly because, I ain't a healer yet, I will be in the end, but I mean, you don't want to be a dick wizard without proper dick wizardry. So next step, I need to take another. I'm really trying to pace this shit out, but yeah, fuck it. Let's do this. All right, here we go. You gotta blow up that bowman. If you can blow up the bowmans, you're pretty good at this. Could you imagine that? Their fucking arms moving like a sewing machine needle, just going up, down, like, and just fucking drilling arrows into everything. I mean, they have nothing to do but practice, but holy shit. There's certain parts of this game you definitely should not play in real speed. I know Pablo's gonna do something horrible with that nya sound. It'll probably be the credits. Ugh. Also, boys and girls, I'm gonna say this. Pablo definitely is one of the most underrated channels on YouTube. He really is a hugely underrated channel on YouTube, and it really hurts me that he is Pablo Ichiban, all one word. And you should definitely check it out. But here's the thing. Not only was he an excellent man to make really high-quality Space Station 13 tutorials, which he did, alongside Spicy Chicken God, both very good tutorial men for Spacemans, what I think is the shame is that Mr. Pablo has not played Dwarf Fortress yet, because holy God, when we turned him loose at my house on Dwarf Fortress, that was magic. That was fucking magic. I mean, he swam through Dwarf Fortress like a fish through water. It was amazing. Lesser Lich.
Yeah, he's a Demi Lich. He's just a little one.
Alright, let's fuck shit up, man. Alright, you ready? Let's blow stuff up. Alright, nope, that goes back down. Sweet. Alright. While I'm still in the business. Quickly. Before this shit wears off. Alright. Okay, Bowman has got a beat on me. There's four of them in this room. Five, I think. Total. Shit. Come on, dog. Because they'll get right up on you and just, like, Mac 10 you in the ribs. And if you're not wearing armor and you don't dodge, you die. Thank you. Where is he? I know he's in here. Yeah, he's right there. Oh my god. I almost exploded from all that. And for my troubles, a fancy ring. But that's not why we're really here. I'm here for levels. Also, what kind of room is this? Like, even if you were the king and queen, that sucks, because anytime you fuck, everyone's gonna hear it. Anytime you fart, anyone's gonna hear it. I mean, it's a suboptimal room for both. Alright, so, fire flash. Because now we are in fireball land, and fireball land is where I live. Are we ready for a most perilous adventure, boys? Alright, gentlemen, to the enemy! Huzzah! Sir, indeed. A most perilous adventure indeed, sir. This coffee is adequate at best. Ugh. Alright, everyone's here. And this area, like many areas in this game, is completely optional. I'll bust you open in a bit. We're gonna clear out all these dungeons, including the really spoopy ones and the not so spoopy ones. We're just gonna go through them and fight them all and make big money. Because this is a money-making enterprise at this point. You know what? Fuck it. Let's bust out the scary magic. Let's bust out the, oh dear god, what spell did he learn magic, right? Okay, here we go. Ow, what a dick. That cost me a lot of mana. Why is he still standing? You're an a-hole. No one likes you. Also, your tattered bowman is just an asshole of a fucking... Alright, you know what? That's it. I'm just gonna harm him. There. Use fire flash for groups. You use harm for individuals. So you can go, like, zombie bowling. Also, fire flash can... It basically does the Molotov cocktail. Molotov cocktail effect, and you can actually blow people around with it. But, you're buying time for your melee characters to get in there and do that. Just get in there and fuck them up. Also in Arcanum, all I believe, unless my recollection is bad, I believe all of your friends, all your little pals in this game, are in the background actually leveling up as you level up. So your dudes get a little more powerful as you go along. That's why some of them skills, like Educator, are actually worth something, where you can train them. You can't have as many followers, but you can actually educate them and get them to be much higher level, or much more apt, should I say, characters. So you can make these people, like, I think it's one step removed. So you can be like the master of melee, and they can be like an expert at melee, which is really cool. Or they could just be like Dog or Sog, who are just incredibly strong and not anything else. Just, they're murder meat puppets. That dwarf is so-so at best. There's some other characters we will meet as we go along, and don't worry. This isn't like a Dragon Age game where they all have tremendously huge, annoying, like, backstories. Some of them just are like, Sog, I am the town drunk. I wouldn't mind getting out of here and making some money. But if you tell me to fuck off, I will go gladly town dump. You know what I mean? These are the things I like. And I will gladly do that. And sometimes I think simplicity in storytelling is best. Like, I think that was one of the big sins that was actually part of the original Halo franchise was... Well, maybe not the original, but in the beginning, people were like, who is John 117? It's like, it's irrelevant. He's a blank slate. You could paint humanity onto him, and that's what he is. He is the vengeful spirit of humanity. He is a tool. His background isn't really necessary to understanding why he does what he does, but then in the more recent ones, in their lore, they decided to make him more vulnerable, which... I really didn't care for, because, I mean, I love I do love Battletech lore, but I love the original Halo lore and settings. I thought they did a really good job building it, and then when it transferred over, they just kind of shit on it in a bad way, and I didn't care for it. Alright, I'm gonna run in this room. Oh my god, I'm the front guy in the door. Breach and clear as a wizard. Is that a giant spike? And that's a Skellington. Okay. Get out of here, Skellingtons. Ow. That hurt. But yeah, look, this place is chock full of levels. You may not realize it, but it is. That's why it's good. Hey. You don't swing at me, bitch. Yeah, that one. I have a dog, you're made of bones, do you really want to fight? It says I'm under attack, but I'm not. Unless they meant, like, by incompetence, because that's, like, ongoing, you know? Alright, let's, just go in the next room, I guess. Oh, yeah, okay, he's gonna bust in here. Oh my god, why is he running in there? Okay, you know what, I can take one of these people. Yeah, nice. Alright, fuck it, let's spill it over, let's have a fight. Yeah, Skellington. Ow. Dogs enjoy snossages and bone. Are these torturing their own Skellington guy? Is this like Skellington North Korea? And that he didn't obey the Skellington leader? And like... Is that what happened? I was trying to come up with a backstory of what happened. And... That's what I'm thinking happened. Like, that was a political prisoner, and we just saved... We came in too late. He's done. You know? He's done. And that's the tragedy of all this. Alright, there's so many bad guys. And there's some giant bad guys in there. And we're gonna fight them all with our power of justice. With our power of justice! Lord's Slave, level 22. Holy crap. More like level fuck me up. Alright, here's what we're gonna do. First things first, we're going to blow him up for Fire Flash. And second thing, I'm gonna count my blessings that I survived that. Because he almost punched me in half. That was kind of metal, and holy shit. I mean, I almost died there, and that was pretty fucking brutal. I mean, I felt like peril was imminent, so, yeah. Quench life. Quench life requires 50 fatigue to cast, but they'd save or die. By the way, look how high my magic aptitude is. Isn't that cool? This is where you can just summon spirits and talk with them. Which allows you to self-murder pretty easily. Mage lock. Yeah, you know what? Yeah, you can actually stop time and then murder people. Which is pretty powerful, to say the least. You know what, I'm gonna start taking spells in this. I know this, some people are gonna get mad because they're like, healing, I thought you were a dink wizard, but with Virgil Gun, this is unavoidable. More Cathorn Crystal, yay. But with Virgil Gun, you really do need a heals man's. Listen to that, yay. You know what, fuck it, let's send the demon in. Yep. Sooner or later, I'll just get the ability to raise the dead at will, and then I'll be able to resurrect people at will, so I can bring it back as a zombie or not a zombie. And now I'm not just a dick wizard. I'm an okay wizard. I'm a 3 out of 4 wizard, you know? Alright, let's do... Put the minor healing there, because we're gonna use the shit out of that. And, I like that there's white and black necromancy. They're, like, both opposites. I think that's kinda nice. But not opposites like George Lucas's definition of opposites, where it's like jazz, and they rhyme, and... Ugh. I want to get that guy a dictionary. Dear George, here's what words really mean. Thank you. I know you're a billionaire, but... Please try harder. Somebody asked me what would I do if I had Jeff Bezos' money, and I was like, definitely not run a company. I would create a real medieval kingdom. Like, I'd just be like, nope, I'm gonna build a bunch of castles. And they're like, what? Why? And I'm like, because I can. I'm gonna hire actors to live there permanently to be, yeah, I'm just gonna hire people to live as their characters in this fantasy kingdom. And I'll just live there. And they're like, you can't live in a fantasy world. And I'm like, au contraire, mon frère. I can do as I please. Alright. Yeah, what's this one? An unlocked door. A torture dungeon. These are the worst skeletons I've ever seen. Report all Skellington crimes to the Skellington Crime Bureau. That's it, rattle 'em, boys. All right, here's what we gotta do. One, we gotta heal everybody. We're running out of heals. We're running out of fatigue potions. I'm gonna have to use the expensive ones. I mean, I know. Basically, this is now the art of transforming your money into help. Oh, God, I forgot on some of that demon. Alright, but yeah, shit. Alright, oof. I'm running low here. I'm running low here, boys. I have a cure-all, which is just some sort of weird biscuit, I think. I always puzzled at what that was supposed to be, even when this thing wasn't in HD, and I had to look at it in its giant pixelated glory. Where is he? No. Where's the manster? Alright, I'll just run this way. Oh boy. Hey, stop that. First of all. Second of all, I will blow you up. Where's the rest of my party? Okay. I'll cast murder on you. How's that? Yeah? Yeah. How's this? How's that, bitch? Oh, he almost... Oh my god. This castle of doom! Do these skeletons know no evil? Ugh. Alright, I'm running out of time on this episode. I got some other business I gotta tend to, so... Let's try to solve this as quick as possible. It sounds like fucking winter. Alright, here we go. Can't believe the evils of these skeletons. The evils know no bounds. The Skeleton Rights Commission will hear of this. Oh my god. Oh my god, he's killing everybody. Jesus. We're terrible at this. Boys. Remember what I taught you, which is nothing. I didn't teach you anything. That we're just adventures. I just pick up literally bums and bars, and I'm like, do you like gold and titties? And they're like, yes. And I'm like, we'll have plenty of both. He's like, I ain't seen nary a pair of breasts nor a coin of gold in a week. And I'm like, yeah, about that. I meant in your imagination these things would be possible. And they just frown, but now that they're so far from society, they require me. And now I've pulled my long con, which is convincing these people I know what I'm doing. You know, that's kind of what people did in the olden days. They just lied through their teeth. I know a route to the new world. We have to sail off the map, though. I've seen it in a dream because the Jesus came to me and told me it. And they're like, oh, sounds reasonable. And then, you know... It worked. Lucky for them. I mean, but still. That or you do stuff like Cortez. I burn my ships and you can't go back. That's cheating! Oh no. No, 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 no. Oh, there. Thank God. Alright. Ugh. Just a few piles of gold, but not really much to show for it otherwise. We're gonna get into the big show here, and yeah, we've got some rough rooms ahead. I'm almost out of potions. It's kind of weird how that worked out. Almost out of potions, but I'm really right up near the end of this. All right, fuckers, here we go. the hugeness of that skeleton has convinced me that I'm going the right place. I also love that in Pablo's tabletop game that he's running on the Saturday Night Boomer Nerd thing, that there's a skeleton that's just like a skeleton farmer, and he's really nice. He's just very polite. Brings us like radishes and stuff. All right, here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna kill this dude first. Yeah, we're gonna kill the shit out of this guy if we can. All right, cool. Now I can send in my boys, because they're all coming after. Ooh.
I've been wounded terribly. Quickly, I need healing.
There's a problem in that, because you are the technology. You know what? Here, let's just give you some drugs. There, he's actually made it, which is amazing. I didn't think that would happen. I thought he would explode. So, anyways, don't worry about it. Gotta keep my strength up. Alright, if we can kill this dude. Come on, demon. Oh my god. Oh my sweet Jesus, did you see that? This beats poor Sog to death. Right, I can pick Sog up after this, but we gotta be careful. Oh, the whole room's full of them. Oh boy. Plus the giant Skellington. He is Skellington, comma large. Demon, attack that guy, please. While I try to flee. Oh, thank God. All right, here's what we gotta do. First of all, I gotta take the Morgana's tears. And then second of all, I have to get that demon to attack that asshole. Yeah, look, Lord of the Damned. You know what? No, I'm just gonna go into options. I'm gonna turn this on fast turn based. I'm gonna let these people sort that out. Because I know when I'm not needed. Hey. Uh-huh. Alright, Sog, get up. You're welcome. You got anything on him? Other than this probably helmet that's not good. Helmet of the not good. Oh, he's got some rings and stuff. What a terrible fucking place. Oh yeah, demon, you can go away now. Thanks. Oh, sorted that out. Nice. Oh, where's the dog? Wait, no, okay, we got the dog, Okay, party is technically full. Technically. Alright, well done, us. Well done. We managed to clear a dungeon. Let's use this scroll of exiting. Ah, good. Most splendid. How often do you, how many asylums do you think would be just filled with adventures, realizing that that was an afternoon at best? It was not really anything to write home about. Ugh, save again, just for good measure. Well, see you next time, friends. See you next time!